A graphic of the Perkins logo swoops across the screen, revealing a chapter heading, Multiple Means of Representation.
There are three principles that help you really look at curriculum and make it smart from the start so it meets the needs of all learners, especially those who have visual impairments and multiple disabilities, including deafblindness. These three principles can help you to see how your curriculum is providing options or really optimizing learning for these learners, and in doing so can provide them with more meaningful and authentic access and engagement with learning that goes on in the classroom. I think that if we think about learners with visual impairment and multiple disabilities, including deafblindness, often in a typical classroom, the concepts are represented through print or through the teacher presenting them to the classroom, and these learners often just don't have basic access to that information because of how it's presented. It's usually tailored to this idea of the average student.
In a photograph, we see examples of multiple means of representation being used to present the concept of multiplication. On a large purple index card, the equation 2 times 3 is written out. Below are two groups of three brightly colored fabric balls. A large yellow index card displays the equation 4 times 2. Above it are four groups of two of the same fabric balls.
So the first principle, multiple means of representation, it allows us to kind of take a step back and think, how can I represent what I am trying to teach my class so that it meets the needs of all learners, including that student who has a visual impairment, including that student who has deafblindness. And in doing that, you start to come up with different ideas, different ways to represent that actually benefit the entire classroom.
In a photograph, a group of first graders walks on a sidewalk through a manicured garden. A sign identifies it as the Garden for the Blind.
Maybe instead of just using a textbook to talk about something abstract like weather, you have the students go outside and experience weather. It works well for the student with deafblindness and the student with visual impairment and multiple disabilities, but it also really works well for all the learners in the classroom.
A graphic lists the first principle, provide multiple means of representation, has these three guidelines. Provide options for perception. Provide options for language, mathematical expressions, and symbols. And provide options for comprehension. Fade to black.